Oh yeah. Whoops, fire trap. Okay, didn't lose too much time. I couldn't afford a coral ring there, so I didn't check. Now I will have enough for two. There we go. Failing a little bit with the gear switching on. There we go. I'm not gonna worry too much about getting XP here, because you get enough on the way back. Chance orb. Remake coast. Oh yeah, move only. Wow. Gotta level these. Gotta get that extra deeps. Oh, fuck. Oh, nice. Got lucky. little bit slow on the glyphs. I can still augment move speed on those boots. These crabs. I'm gonna block them away. Already four though. God damn it. I may augment those. As a matter of fact, I will augment them. 15 life. Oh wow, Jade Amulet early. Holy shit, that's huge. That's actually fucking huge. That just saved me a transmute, and it means I'm gonna level my fire trap at 8. Those are gonna get vendored no matter what the roll is. I need to get the transmutes and ults. Chestplate. Blue. That's the reason I want it. It has Colbrez, but I'm gonna sell it anyways because I need the shit. Very low on Scrolls of Wisdom too. At the moment, Transmute, that's gonna be really helpful. There's four Wisdoms right there. Hello to everybody coming in. I'm kind of surprised I actually have 30 viewers right now. I must have been at the top of the ladder at some point. Early on. All things to get vendored. Another orbit transmutation. I can vendor one now. So I now have 8 wisdoms, which is great. That's enough to get 2 cold rings and a leather belt. Blue-green Driftwood Scepter, that's one that gets ID'd. I'll definitely identify that. If it has +1 fire, that's even more huge. Any plus gems, actually, that's pretty big. I'm able to level Fire Trap here because I got that Jade Amulet drop. Scroll of Wisdom. Int. Leech. I'm still going to use it just because extra bonus. A little bit of extra bonus. Doesn't really help me amazingly, but it's bonus. I'm keeping these gloves because they're blue linked. I'm gonna use my Quicksilver here. This might go a little bit badly because of bad gear, but I do have a lot of life. Risky move, I know. Alright. So I need to vendor that and that. Vendor these. Damn it. I'm just barely short. Get the iron ring. We'll come back to it later. And rustics or leather belts couldn't spawn right then. Oh, I forgot to sell this. That would have done it. Let's hope for some armor scraps and shit. We're gonna transmute this ahead of time. It can't get +1, just from a transmute, but you can craft it into a +1. Ice Nova goes there, Fire Trap there. And the reason I'm moving those there right now is so that I have an easier time getting it into the vendor. I don't have to unsocket everything ahead of time, and I get to progress a little bit. So I do have enough. Okay. I have a chest on now. Now we're gonna zoom past this dog. We went around the outside because there were a lot of mobs on the inside and I would have gotten blocked. Prestidigitation gives us some cast speed. Heavy belt gives life, so I'm replacing my chain belt with that. Nice pack to finish off this area. I could use a small mono flask to craft a flask, but whatever. Really hoping for some wisdom scrolls right now. Topaz ring. Well, that saves me a vendor trip in Act 2. Okay, armored scrap, that's another 2 wisdoms, so I have 4 wisdoms. I actually have 6 if I vendor all my blues and trade in the scraps for wisdom scrolls, which is not a bad idea at this point. I'm trying to hit 10 before Cove so I can get the full XP out of it. There we go. And be able to use Flame Blast. Rain of Arrows, lol. So we're in Coves. Alchemy. That's going to be used on some boots until I get some move speed. I'll probably hold off on alking any boots until I know they're item level 15. Because that's when you can get 15 move speed instead of 10. Armor scrap. I do need the wisdoms really bad right now, so I'm going to struggle through that for that. Blue pack before the god tier blue pack. You'll see what I'm talking about the god tier blue pack in a second. Sapphire ring, it saves 3. God tier blue pack coming up. Not so god tier today. Careful of the Vuln. As I nearly get wrecked. And that was the god tier blue pack. Gonna go back to town, get the added lightning, craft my plus one. I already have one cold ring, which is good. Whoa. Got another transmute. Got some cold rings. 27, 37. We're good. So you may be wondering why I'm keeping the chest. You'll see that. So now we got our plus one fire. And we're in Caverns of Anger. Definitely don't need a chest for this part. There's only crabs here that hit. Just watch for this guy. He hits hard. You can also kill that pack really quick like that. Always spawns there. Whoops. Spark is not supposed to be in that spot. Alright, we put on the evasion chest, cold rings. Wow, really unlucky. I guess my evasion gear wasn't exactly the best. I wasn't wearing a tricorn, I was wearing a leather cap, and I was wearing fish scale gauntlets, so it's kind of makes sense. Another jade amulet. This one's 28, should be fine. The roll on it doesn't matter too much anyways. Probably should have picked up that salad. Velvet slippers. Likely gonna elk those. Alchem. Move speed. There we go. Alright, we're gonna switch back our rings in a second. Fire damage. Move speed, fire res too. That's insane. What up, Lee Sin? And thank you, Gucci Pradas. Strength into Blackwood. I'm going to actually craft a second lightning ring just to make this safe.
You're listening to the Transactional Podcast, and we're in the mix with me, Tristan C. Don't forget, you can get all the information and the tracks that we're playing on the podcast on our Podomatic page or our SoundCloud page.
Alchemy.
And don't forget to subscribe to the podcast on iTunes.
Best use that on the belt.
Now, at the end of my mix,
for Flask. Stun Recov. It's actually more useful than you think. You can save lives. The life recovery is pretty nice too. transmute my Quicksilver really quickly right before I level, so I can get the full effect of it. Boom. Instant charge. Strength. Not bad. Hoping to find a Quartz Scepter soon. Ah, yeah, that happens, Aisha. You gotta be careful in those tight spaces. I really need to upgrade my gear, though. Plus one cold. Useless at this point. Fourteen mana regen. That's a nice upgrade. Oh my god! Wrecked! That crit, though. Yeah. Still, it's progress. Every racer got their start somewhere. That used to be a really good Merville time. I used to win races with that. Just on. My God! Are you kidding me? That just happened! Oh, wow! Wow! Oh my God! That is unbelievable! Wow! Oh my God! The amount of time I just saved on those two parts is unreal. I'm actually going to be ahead. Holy shit. Don't fuck with these rare guys, oh my God. Plus one coal, damn. I don't want to fight that. Clean instance. Not gonna fight that rare, it's fire res, no point. What's good is that I don't really need to worry about fire res too much right now, because I do have 17 on the boots and I have 12 on the tree. Yeah. Wow, clean as fuck. Clean as fuck. Powerful crits. That's puncture. Rare and rare. Don't want to do it. Skill points to strength, so I'll deal with it in a second. And then the next few skill points are gonna be nothing. Oh wait, there's a way down here, okay. Thought I was gonna have to fight through that mob. That was a lot of archers. If I were to get caught on something in that, that would have been really bad. What? Clean as fuck, yes. Oh, Vaughn. Got a lot of XP in that zone though, which is very surprising. Shit, that was really dangerous. Don't try that one at home. Those were some crazy fucking pack size. I want to hit 21 before the boss. I'm gonna speed up the kill slightly. Unfortunately, I got a really bad ancient. But there is a shrine coming up, so hopefully I can get enough XP off that. Oh, this looks good. Damn it. I'm not gonna end up using this. Oh, fuck. Now, $67.55.41, holy god. Perpetus is on my fucking dick. Nice helmet. I don't need this helmet anymore after I get Searing Bond, so. Wow, fucking Soul Conduit, dude. File touch. I see blues. I see more blues. Alright, I'm gonna try a new strat during this run. Should hopefully save some time. Spark is useless to me now. Only reason I was leveling it was because if I get a Vel Orb, I wanted to make a Vel Spark. These fucking mobs, though. The corrupt zone's always there, but it's random mods. Alright, so do that. Slight time save.
Enough of this!
I'm gonna buy some portals. I don't have fucking Ancestral Bond. There we go.
so you've been listening to me, Tristan C, in the mix here on the Trance Sanctuary podcast. I had to do it, I had to fit in a couple of classics there. Love this one, Dreamland, New NRG. And before that, FKN's Y, the Alien Filler remix. One of my all-time favourites, had to be done really. I'm sure we can fit a couple of classics into our back-to-back set, myself and Mark. On the 9th of November.
Lucky on that.
So I hope that's got you well and truly in the mood and give you sort of a
mob.
The sort of thing you can expect from Mark and myself at Trance Sanctuary and at the Egg. Can't wait for that. Right, now I did promise earlier that we'd be running a competition. We are running a competition for our next event on the 9th of November at the Egg for Trance Sanctuary presents Daniel Candy and Alex Morph. And right now I'm going to tell you how you can get your hands on two guest list passes for that very event. So how do you do that? Well, we're going to be running a very simple question for this. And I'll hit you with that question right now. The question is, Daniel Candy has remixed two of Alex Morph's tracks in the past. Can you name one of them? I'll give you that one more time. Daniel Candy has remixed two of Alex Morph's tracks in the past. Can you name one of them? Send your answers to email address info@trancesanctuary.com. That's info@trancesanctuary.com. Closing date for the competition is Thursday the 7th of November. So make sure you get your entries into us before then. If you're listening to this after the event, obviously the competition is closed. Emailing the winner of the competition on the same date, the 7th of November, to let them know they've won those two guest list entries passes for Trance Sanctuary. Great stuff. Good luck with that. Right, I'm going to be welcoming onto the decks in just a minute the one and only Neptune Project. Before that, one more tune from me. Had to play this one. This is one of my favourite tunes of the year so far. Richard Duran, Trancematic. Check this out.
I've got really good XP right now. This might be a record. This could very, very well be a record. I'm running extremely well. I'm barely before 24, or 26, or 26 rather, so I should be fine going into docks. Cold and fire are capped. Unbelievable.
What a tune, what a tune. Right, that's been me in the mix. We're now going to be changing styles a little bit, and we're going to be going in the mix with the one only Neptune Project coming up next on the Trance Sanctuary podcast.
This is the Trance Sanctuary podcast.
one and only Neptune Project. Big fans of these guys, very much looking forward to seeing them play live at Trans Sanctuary on the 9th of November. So who are Neptune Project? Well, they're actually a couple of lads, Dan Willis and Jules Moyse. They're from Swindon, and recently they've been...
Cast Speed, oh my god.
Taking Storm wherever they go, of course. They're known for their uplifting, banging trance, and they're signed to...
I have an unbelievable amount of life right now.
And on the 9th of November, they'll be making their Trans Sanctuary debut.
Totem Life.
And ahead of that, we are very pleased to present a live recording of one of their recent sets out in Argentina. This is pretty special, guys, so crank it right up.
70 fire res
this
with
the Trans Sanctuary podcast, and we're going in the mix.
No chest.
Check this out.
Blue pack over here. There is no doubt this is record pace. ES mob, not gonna kill it. Damn. I'm hoping for an adrenaline suffix on something. Oh, maybe this isn't record. The fuck? I went wrong somewhere. Oh, it's the lack of double quicksilver, I think, maybe. Weird. I miscalculated somewhere. This isn't a record run, but it's still a good run. Wait. No, it's 6.4 that I need, not 7.4. What the fuck? I'm on drugs. .7 with 3 minutes left. Oh my god, please keep giving me these packs. .9 with 3 minutes to go. Oh my god. Come on. Enfeeble, thank God. We in there. Oh yeah, this is a record. This is 100% a record. Oh wow, 6.5. Oh my god, can I break 7? Oh, 6.7. That's it. That's the end. I can't reset, unfortunately, because it's just going to say league's over. I'm going to get an extra blue. Awesome. Oh. .7. Wow. Oh my god. What a fucking run. What a fucking run. Holy shit. I don't see a single place where I played bad. I don't see a single place where I played bad. Unreal. unfucking real. I now hold the record by 337k. Oh my god, that was amazing. Wow. Oh my god. I don't see a single place where I played badly. I'm actually gonna save these splits, but oh my god, I really, oh my god. I'm really happy with this.